Let your meditation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving let your requests be known unto God. Be made known unto God. Be careful. I'm going to read that again. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. Let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is a hand. Okay? Amen. At hand. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God.
That's right.
And the peace of God, serve me, and the peace of God which passeth all understanding shall keep your heart and your mind through Christ Jesus.
Amen.
This, my friend, has been penned by Paul. And it's talking about rejoicing in the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
As a Christian, we need to know where our help comes from.
That's right.
We need to know and understand what who God is and what He can do for us. The song said that prayer can change anything.
Mm-hmm.
And when you pray to the Holy, the Almighty, and All-Wise God, He can change anything.
Amen.
Make your request known unto Him.
Yes.
Supplication is your request. Make it known unto Him. Believe it in your heart, you shall receive what you believe.
Amen.
And today we're here talking about what the people of this of Philippians, what they were going through. Paul was trying to encourage them not to be taken away in what they go through. For he was in jail at the time when he would write this letter of encouragement to these people.
Mm-hmm.
He was in jail and he didn't know whether he was going to be released or crucified. He knew one of the two was going to happen.
That's right.
But this time he was released, but he didn't know this. But in all that he done, he was still encouraging them to have joy. For he said he got joy in his soul. We need joy in order to serve the Lord. If you don't have joy, you can't serve God. That you say, there's a, let me tell you, happiness and joy is two different little animals. That's two different people. Happiness comes when you get a birthday present, a Christmas present, a new dress, a new car, a new house, a new hit the lotto. This is joy when it comes. That's happiness. Happiness comes with happenings. Okay? Things got to happen for you to get happy. But joy comes through only Jesus. The one that shed the blood on Calvary. Joy is when everything else, when all hell had broke loose, and you still look up and say, God, I thank you.
Yes.
Joy comes when trouble arises in your soul, and you have, look like to me, everybody, everything is going on, and you begin to call on the name of Jesus and say, God, we'll change this thing, God. And way deep down on the inside, although your bills are not paid, your lights are turned off, the man is backing up to the door to pick up your car, the four-cold man is putting a lamp on, step on your door, you can look up and say, God, I thank you, but it could have been another way. I couldn't even be able to see this thing. But God will bring you out. Then you can start praying, God, I know you got something that's better for me.
Amen.
Believe in your heart. Joy is when you know that you know you got a Savior that got all powers in your hand. Happy folk don't understand it. Happy people don't understand the joy of Jesus. You know why, Sister Peace, they don't understand the joy of Jesus? Because when that money, when that bank account is in the negative and runs to zero, they get all turned on. You start searching for all different kinds of things. But when a Christian bank account get in the red, they'll say, Lord, here am I again. Send me some money somewhere. I need a financial blessing. Then they start talking about the money all in the fish mouth. Uh-huh. The song that talk about how God sent manna from heaven. Bread and meat both fell down, so they tell me. If God can do those things, what more do you want Him? That's our joy. You got to have joy in Jesus. You got to have the joy that Jesus intended for us to have, to hold fast until he come back.
Amen.
See, if you hold fast until God goes back, the greatest joy there is the crown of heaven.
Amen.
You got to rejoice in all that God do for you. The Bible here said rejoice. The Bible said rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. You don't rejoice for you. Look, a Christian, you don't get rejoiced just because you can talk to the devil and he back up on you. We need to rejoice that our name is being written up in glory.
Amen.
That we are serving a master according to his will and his way.
Amen.
That we are doing something according to the will of God. We're not going to take down this love. The world is in a turmoil. Sister, I'm like you. I want Obama to win. But if Obama, by any measure, Obama do not win, I'm not worried, I'm not displeased. I'm going to rejoice in God. Why? Because I know God got my back. I know there's a ghost up in heaven for me. I know that down here God will take care of me. In spite of all the situations, all the political campaigns, I know God is able to do anything but fail. Because if that gives me joy on the inside, it gives me peace on the inside. If you want some joy, you got joy to bring about peace.
That's right.
See, the devil come and try to sell you stuff. The devil come and tell you right quick, God can't do it for you. Look at your neighbor. Say, devil, ain't buying it.
Devil ain't buying it.
Don't let him sell you a bill of goods that's not good for you. Don't you let the devil come in and tell you God ain't God. He really? Don't you let him tell you that God is asleep. Don't you let him tell you God don't love you. You look at your neighbor and say, devil, I ain't buying it.
Devil ain't buying it.
He will sell you whatever you let him sell you to take away your joy.
Amen.
He can have my happiness.
Mm-hmm.
He can have your happiness. If he come get the house, that's all right. If he come get the car, that's all right. If he messes my bank account, that's all right. Because I know if I hold fast to the will of God, if I keep my faith, my joy, which is my peace, my love, my understanding, I keep praying and making supplications before the mouth, there's going to be a turn in the situation after a while.
Oh, yeah.
See, sometimes our trials and tribulations come to what? Make us strong.
Yeah, that's right.
If you want to get strong in the natural, my baby here used to lift weights. Pastor Corey used to lift weights. The more weights he lift, the bigger muscle he got.
Mm-hmm.
The more weights you lift, the bigger your muscle are. The more trials you go through and you go through with Christ, the bigger your Christian man gonna be. The bigger the stronger your Christian man gonna be. And after a while, you'll be walking around all bust up in the spirit. Because God Almighty, we made you strong. Oh, I ain't worried about the muscles in the natural. But you got to be bust in Jesus. You got to have some joy on the inside. You got to have something that'll get you through a storm of weather.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about? When it's hailing outside, when it's raining out there, when the typhoon comes, when the hurricane comes, when the tornadoes come, you got to have some joy. And set with your peace of heart knowing that God has got you over troubled water. He said he'll be a shelter in the time of storm. He'll be in the down bridge over troubled water. He said he's a battle axe in the time of war. He said he can save your soul. He can pick you up and make you whole. He said if you trust me, God, I'll bring you out. If you don't back up, boy, I got you. If you don't let go, I'll hold you. If you just keep on keeping on, God, I'll get there with you. You got to let God hold you. Keep your joy. But the devil will come and tell you it's different.
Mm-hmm.
That means he said, devil ain't buying it.
Devil ain't buying it.
Woo, glory be to God. See, God will show you something that man don't know. All that you need, I sing a song. All that I need is in Jesus.
Uh-huh.
Joy, he supplied.
Yeah.
He will give you everything you need and want.
Yeah.
But you got to first seek him. You got to pray to him. You got to make your prayer, your request known unto him. You got to qualify. You got to lift some weights. You got to go through some stuff. You can't just do what you want to. You can't lay down and let the devil walk all over you. And then get up and pray and tell God, I know you're real. Because see, when you start worrying, when you start bagging up, when you start falling out crying, when you lose all hope, when you lose your mind, then the devil know that you're weak and you're not trusting in Jesus. can do anything but fail.
That's right.
And he never fails. But the reason he don't come through is because we let go.
Amen.
We buy that ticket that devil sell us. We buy that bill of goods that the devil tell us we can't get to Christ. You better know what you're doing. Know that the joy of the Lord is your strength.
Yes.
Glory be to God. I am so glad on today that the Lord brought me from a mighty long way.
Yes.
I told somebody that I have sold out to Christ. Paul said that he passed for the mark of the high calling, which is in Jesus Christ. Paul said he learned how to be obeyed and abound. He learned how to be happy. He got joy when he was hungry. He got joy when he was filled. He got joy when he was walking around free. He got joy when he was down. He got joy when he was free.